Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is another Verilog project which is clock generator with alarm. So let us get accustomed to the features of our project. First of them being is the clock generation. Then we have initializing clock time to a particular value. We can set the alarm, we can enable and disable the alarm, and also we can stop the alarm in a clock. So this is the block diagram of our alarm clock. First we have the reset. This will basically reset the clock. Next we have the clock. This is a simple 10 MHz clock. Next we have hour input and minute input, which will be used to set the time and also to set the alarm. Next we have load time. This will be used to load the time. Load alarm. This will be used to load the alarm time. At last we have stop alarm as input and alarm on as input. Stop alarm will stop the alarm. Alarm on, till the time alarm on is on, the alarm will ring, and as soon as it gets off, alarm will get off. For outputs we have alarm. This is the output for alarm. And also then we have hour out, minute out and seconds out. This will basically show the time. Next we have the flowchart. Now what I want is that you should get accustomed to this flowchart, because when I'll show you the Verilog code, this will be based on this flowchart only. So first of all, if the reset, so this diamond shape means if statement, right? So if the reset is yes, then basically set the alarm to zero and set the time to given input time, right? If the reset is not zero, then this is clock 1 second. So basically our clock keeps on running, right? Our clock keeps on running, and then you see if load alarm is yes, then you have to set the alarm, right? You have to load in the alarm time. If no, then you check for load time. If load time is yes, then you set the time to the given input time. If not, then it works normally. The clock works normally. Next, you check if alarm time is equal to real time. If it happens, then alarm on gets on, right? So you raise the output alarm. If not, then simply you just keep on going, right? And after raising output alarm, you have to make sure that you have to stop the alarm as well. So when stop alarm is high, then you lower the alarm up. So now we'll be looking at the Verilog code. So starting from the Verilog code, this is the Verilog code. Initially we have the initializations which we have discussed before. Next we have a mod 10 function. So this is an if else statement, right? So what this function is doing is simply, I'll tell you a simple function. What it will do is, if I give it a number 54, it will give the 10th digit, which is 5, right? So this function we have used, I'll tell you where we have used it. Next we have the reset clock part, right? So if reset is high, then what you do is, you set everything to 00, right? This is what is happening here. Next, we have the set alarm part. If load alarm is high, then you simply load the alarm. Which inputs were there for HN1, HN2? These were the inputs for hours, for minutes, right? You just load into it for as the alarm time. Next, now we are trying to load time, right? So if load time is high, then you simply load the time, the H input 1, the H input 0, minute input 1, minute input 0, right? You load it. Next, what we are doing is increment time. So if we are not loading, so that's why we have an else statement here. Now, then you simply increment the time, right? This is pretty simple. Now, this is 1 second clock. So basically what all this code is doing is, this will increment everything only by 1 second, right? Next, this is for our output time. So here we have used that mod, right? Mod 10. So first of all, okay. So for output time, we say if the temp R variable is greater than 20, then simply R1. So this was the, so R clock is a 24 hour clock. So MSB, which would happen. So if time is more than 20, simply you say MSB is 2. If time is greater than 10, you simply say, and less than 20, simply say MSB is 1. Otherwise, MSB is 0, right? So, next we calculate the R0 bit for 0th bit for the R, right? Now, for the minute, see, I told you, right? Mod 10, what will mod 10 will do? It will simply pick out the tens digit, right? So if our temp minute would be giving a value 54, simply you say that the MSB for minute bit is 5, right? Similarly, calculate the LSB for minute bit, and this is how we are calculating the output time. So next we have setting and disabling of alarm, right? So again, if reset is 1, alarm is 0. This part is easy enough. Now we say if the time which we had set comes equal to the time which was for load alarm, right? Then alarm gets on for the time period for which AL on is high, right? So this is setting and disabling of alarm. Now let us have a look at the test bench code. So first of all, we have the definitions, then we have the module instantiation. Like this is pretty standard, nothing to explain here. Next, so we have the clock definition, and these are the inputs we have initialized. So when I'll show you the waveform, I want you to notice that this all is what I have put in the waveform, right? First the reset would be 1, HN would be 1, HN 0 would be 0. So these are all the inputs which I have put in the waveform. So you got to note that, right? Next is the simulation output. But before going to the simulation output, first let us see the Vivado project as well. This is the exact same Verilog code we have discussed in the presentation, and I'll be linking this code in the description as well. Also, the exact same test bench we have discussed in the presentation. To save the time, I have already simulated. So let us have a look at the waveforms. So here, I want you to note that the reset is 1. As soon as the reset gets 0, now a clock is in the working condition. Here, load alarm is high. So what are we trying to do is, we are trying to load the alarm time, right? And what time are we going to load is, we check from here. The hours is 10 and the minutes is 20. So we are loading 10:20. So ideally our alarm should ring at 10:20. Also, I want you to note one more thing, that a clock is working fine since the seconds output is incrementing by 1 after 1 second. So now let us see whether our alarm is working or not. Here already we have discussed that alarm we have set as 10:20. This is the output time. Now let us see. Here the time is 10:19 and the seconds are 58. Now we have seconds as 59. As soon as the time goes to 10:20, 00 second, the alarm rings. Here this waveform in the aqua color represents the alarm, and it rings till the stop alarm is low. As soon as the stop alarm here gets high, the alarm stops. Hence, we have verified the working of our alarm clock and our project is working great. Here, I also want to thank Mehak Jain for researching on the project and writing the Verilog code